following show is paid programming and does not necessarily express the views and opinions of Urban Broadcast Media and its subsidiaries.
Thank you for listening to UBM Praise. Go.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
What's his name?
Sir Walter Jones.
Whose show is this?
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
Say it again.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who are you with?
Sir Walter Jones.
One more game.
Sir Walter Jones.
The Sir Walter Jones Show. Co-host Alvin Carter. We are a Christian talk show in where we tackle all the hot topics in a believer's walk.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
What's his name?
Sir Walter Jones.
Whose show is this?
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
Say it again.
It's Fireside Friday. Sit back, relax, grab some tea and crumpets, and let's talk about the current events of the week. Right here on the Sir Walter Jones Show.
Hello, everybody. Sir Walter, the Sir Walter Jones Show. I'm here. It is Friday. Fireside Friday. We're going to sit around the mic and talk about the current events of the week. Week of February 22, 2016. For those of you who are listening to me in the year 2029, that's what day it is today. It's still Black History Month, and we got about a few days left, and we're going to shut it down. No more hearing about Martin Luther King and Sojourner and her truth. Just for more days, and that's it. It's over. We got a lot of news to talk about today, and especially the events that happened today in itself. My goodness, today. The great Christie from the historical state of, way from Jersey. He from Jersey, and he decided to step behind Donald Trump. Now, that was a shocker to me, believe it or not. Let's talk about that today. And those of you who are in Chicago, who live here, and you are so thankful for your corporation and company or your job not closing, keep praying. Because if your job or corporation if Illinois has anything to do with your doors staying open, I just need you to just bow your head and pray right now. Because, you know, we were listening to the news on our way to see my grandmother, who is, she had a wonderful Black History Month program today. And I was brought in to teach the elderly something about Black African American, or Black history, or Negro history, or I don't know what it was, but I had a great time. But I was listening to the news, and they said that Chicago State passed out 900 pink slips today. Even the president got a pink slip. You got to understand the setup here. And I was I put that on Facebook, and I think it was Chris Patterson. He began to remind us of all the other organizations that are affected by the state. You know, we got this new governor in, Rauner, and he is doing what he feels he needs to do. And we're at a stalemate right now, and it's affecting so many people. But Chris Patterson was talking about how, why is it that we're so upset about the Chicago State closing, but when there are other entities that are being affected by this? And I hear what he's saying. We're not just crying about Chicago State. I'm crying about Western Illinois University because my daughter's there. You know, she's there. This is her third year, and I can't have them closing the doors when she's this close. But he says, we've been hearing about the closing for months. I want to know, why is it Northeastern Illinois University or Governor State or UIC not preparing to close just yet? Why Chicago State closing sooner than these schools? They're all publicly funded. Were they getting their fair share of funds from the state? Chicago State I think they get about 30% from the state, and the rest of it comes from you. You know, it comes from some of you who don't qualify for any type of aid, so you come out your pocket. The others come from private fundings, fundraisers, cookie sales. That's right, athletics, big tickets for that. But apparently all that other stuff, you know, just wasn't enough. The 70% that comes in through all that, it's not going to be enough. And they, I can't remember what their monthly budget is, but it's not enough. And they had to shut down spring break. They had to cut it short. And they, last minute, they gave the people a notice. Says, sorry, y'all. Y'all got to come back to work. Spring break is over. And people put bought plane tickets, and rented the condos for the week in Florida somewhere, and they can't go. But my heart goes out to those 900 people who will probably not be working come fall. So anyway, that's that news. Brittany, come over here and talk to me, baby. Since you're so pretty and all that stuff. I got my wonderful investigative reporter, Marilyn Keeter.
Oh, I was like, I'm not
sure. No, you're not. No. We'll catch up on the weekend right quick. We're not going to be here till 5 o'clock. And I got so much stuff going on. Over a span of 7 hours, just that Uber situation. Remember the Uber driver just a few days ago, Jason Dalton? Killed 6 people and injured 2 in Kalamazoo, Michigan. None of the victims knew each other, and the motive of this time is not really clear, but the shootings took place in various locations. Now, this boy was driving around, picking up Uber people.
Yeah.
Passengers. And then shooting folk and then picking up passengers.
Mm-hmm.
You heard that story?
Yes.
What do you think about that? You think something wrong with him?
Well, an understatement.
That's a dumb moment.
Yeah.
Because in court, he seemed like he had all his scruples.
I'm sure sociopaths have their scruples, I mean,
he fat, so to me, he was socially able to eat.
Yes, that too.
Okay.
But I mean, he randomly shoot. There's no motive known right now. He just randomly shot some people, and then he tried to shoot some kids and a woman, shielded the kids and things like that. It's
that's something.
It's just evil. He doesn't have a motive, and it wasn't. He just shot some people, and then to go to work in between is just
like very, nothing happened.
Yeah,
he had an out of body experience. He something snapped. I think he probably was like this all the time. Now, people are saying, okay, Uber, what's going on? You don't vet your people properly. Well, Uber don't know.
They did a background check on him, and it came up with nothing.
Okay.
So
and that background checks are not 100% sound.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because background checks simply means that you didn't catch a crazy man, because the crazy man never got caught.
Right.
So his background check is going to be clear. All right. If you don't have a police report anything from a doctor or something like that, because he never got caught, you know, or never checked himself in, or family never, you know. So you can't be blaming Uber. They did what they was right. Now, I will say that the Uber and Lyft do something different, though, because Uber, you don't ever really see anybody. It's all through, you know, through the electronic. Mm-hmm. But I think Lyft, you know, they actually come see about you.
Oh, okay.
That's what I hear on the news. You know?
Okay.
They actually have representatives here in Chicago and what have you. All right, that's interesting. But the 31st Annual Stellar Awards, the biggest event in gospel took place Saturday at the Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. I think I saw my brother Larry there and his wife and a few other friends. We were invited to go there. We were supposed to represent Urban Broadcast Media, but so much was going on that weekend. I just couldn't go. Hosted by Ricky Smiley and Sherry Shepherd, and the awards ceremony honored the gospel artists and groups of 28 categories. Summary of 2016 Stellar Awards. Top nominees, Anthony Brown and Group Therapy, 10 total nominations. Charles Jenkins in the Fellowship got 8. Erica Campbell got 8.
I love God.
You love God? Brittany, do you love God?
I forgot the rest of that.
What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with you, yes.
Mm-hmm.
I love him. I love him.
I love him. Love him. Got Brittany going. Tasha Cobbs got 6 nominations. Richard Smallwood, 5. Israel and New Breed, 4. Jonathan McReynolds, our dear friend, brother, son, nephew, 4. KCJ got 3. Tina Campbell got 3. That's Erica's sister, by the way.
Yes, I know. I've seen her. The commercial from the reality show.
Oh, yeah. There you go. She loved her. Dorinda Clark got 3, and the Ramsey Allen Group's got 3 nominations. All these nominations. The Megabus Blues, that Marilyn Keeter, boy, she is one writer. But yeah, you heard about the fire?
No. What happened?
After hearing a loud pop accompanied by fire coming from the tire, a Megabus driver quickly escorted the passengers from the bus that was headed to Minnesota. Man, within seconds later, the bus was engulfed in flames. Passengers' luggage was lost, but their lives were saved. The occurrence happened near Lake Forest Hospital. Passengers were able to walk to the hospital, where they waited about an hour for another bus. I saw that thing. It was an inferno, okay? Everybody's luggage was gone, and the guy was like, man, I lost everything, man. My license, social security number, all my everything. Because, you know, some people who ride these buses, that luggage, that's all they have.
Mm-hmm.
Some of these people live out of that luggage.
Right.
And so, gosh, come to find out later on that there was some type of design flaw. That's what that thing caught on fire. So I'm wondering, are they going to suspend? Sue, but also suspend Megabus for a little while until they figure out what was the design flaw on that particular bus or the entire fleet. We need to figure that out.
Yes.
I'm surprised you didn't see that because, you know, you're such a nerd like myself.
I'm surprised I didn't see that either.
Mm-hmm. A presidential update and dropouts. Clinton beat Sanders in the Nevada caucus, winning 53% Sanders 74%.
Okay. I remember that.
Yep. In South Carolina, Trump leads 32%, with Rubio coming in second, with Cruz taking the third. The next dropout for the presidential race came as no surprise. Jeb.
Mm-hmm.
Jeb gone.
He left.
Please clap.
I can't clap with one hand, so.
That's what he said. He said, please clap. suspended with White House campaign and acknowledged a painful reality. The country was not interested in a third presidential Bush. Yes.
That's an understatement.
That is. And Mama told him, you know, y'all should listen to him. And he spent millions, millions and millions of dollars on this campaign.
He did.
He did what they call a shock and awe.
Mm-hmm.
And it shocked him. And we were like, oh, gone. And Weight Watchers, this is not in the report from Keeter, but Weight Watchers, I was listening to the news today. You know, Oprah Winfrey is now
the spokesperson
for Weight Watchers. She put millions into that. OK, plus, of course, Weight Watchers, you know, betting on her.
Mm-hmm.
Come to find out, Weight Watchers, they took a dump this week.
Yeah. The stock plummeted. She lost $24 million. Which is chump change for her, right. Honestly.
Right, exactly. Can you? That's embarrassing.
Mm-hmm.
I know they were celebrating and jumping up and down and having parties when Oprah joined forces with them.
Thinking, yeah, because it rose. The stocks rose at first.
Yeah, it did.
And then they.
And it plummeted. That's so embarrassing. All right, we're going to Monday. Albert Woodfox, his time outside of solitary confinement. Okay, who's that? After spending 44 years in solitary confinement at the Louisiana State Penitentiary, commonly known as Angola, Albert Woodfox made Monday's headlines news as he spoke out against and about his treatment and the treatment of other inmates. You know anything about this?
No, I don't.
I don't either. Woodfox appeared to...
Hmm.
Yeah.
Tell me more.
No, I ain't got time.
Okay.
I don't have time.
Never mind.
I have to read this on my own to see who is this Woodfox. Y'all hit me out on Facebook. Who's Albert Woodfox? And what's going on with this? I'm surprised I don't know about that one. But Fiji hit by a record storm. The Pacific island of Fiji has been hit by a most powerful storm ever recorded in the Southern Hemisphere. Did you hear about that one?
Vaguely.
Wow. Cyclone Winston killed 17 people and destroyed entire villages. Good Lord. And cyclone. You rarely ever hear about a cyclone. Next in the news, that set right up, folks, pay a fee and board the Ark. Keita, she says that this is no new news other than what Pastor Richard Green in Frostburg, Maryland, is trying to accomplish. The rebuilding of the Ark, Noah's Ark. You anything about this?
No, why is he rebuilding the ark?
Well, now in his final stages, the 450 feet long, 75 feet wide, 45 feet high replica will house real animals as visitors from all over will come and tour. Pastor Green, he was bored.
He was bored.
He says he claimed that he received a heavenly visitation from the Lord telling him to rebuild the ark as a last day witness to the world.
So how's he going to take care of the animals?
Ooh, great question.
How's he going to pay to get these animals?
Ooh, second great question. two spectators came out to look at the building progress and they were healed, it says. One of the bronchitis, you know, I can't debate any of this stuff. I can't doubt any of it because I was not there, so I'm going to move on. Today in history, 1950s. Mm-hmm. Julius Winfield Irving. Dr. J.
Okay. At first, you said it so long. I was like, who is this person?
He was born today. Happy birthday, Dr. J. Man, I'm a poor. I didn't know it. 1989, DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. Won first rap Grammy for the hit Parents Just Don't Understand. Do you remember that song?
Yes, it came out when I was two, but I remember. One or two, but
one
I remember.
One or two. Okay. February 23rd. This is Tuesday. Fire and bullets leave five dead. Phoenix police and firefighters dealt with fire and bullets going on at the same time in a home in which three adults, a child, and the gunman were all family members. The gunman shot at police while firefighters battled the blaze. Hear about this?
Yes.
An 911 call from inside the house begged for help and said the situation was domestic related. The shooter set the house on fire and was later killed by police. Oh, thank God they killed him. I wish these guys would just kill themselves first before they go on a shooting rampage.
It's a lot of domestic dispute stuff where the person, a family member, is murdering their children or their spouse and then themselves or their brother and sister. It's very disturbing.
It's disturbing. It's demonic. I know you're not all into what we do here, Brittany, but it's demonic. I need you to know that. All right. Tap into that. Okay. We'll have an altar call after this service is over.
Okay.
Supervised injection sites. 28-year-old Svante Merrick, mayor of Ithaca, New York, is a full supporter of his city of 30,000 people to have a facility which allows the illegal use of heroin to be fully supervised by nurses. Did you hear this?
Yes, I did.
Wait, Blackhawks trade somebody today. I just popped up on my phone.
Okay, that shouldn't come in with the heroin injection.
Yeah, you know, I had to read it really fast because it popped up right over it. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you know, because, you know, you're a Blackhawk fan. You know, I...
Yes.
That's so important for... well, they trade Rob Scuderi, is that his name?
Scuderi,
yeah,
yes.
To the Kings.
Yes, and they got Christian Erroff. I forgot how to say his name.
Oh, you sad about this?
No, he was barely on the team.
Oh, okay, good.
Then he was on waivers, yeah.
Waivers. Oh, okay, I'm going to say he waivers.
No, he might.
Okay, so supervised injection. So you heard about this?
Yes.
Help me out with this story.
The only thing I heard is that, he wants basically for them to be able to get injections of heroin legally without getting arrested. Because, you know, when you if you're a heroin addict, if you don't take heroin, you're in a bad way.
Absolutely.
So I think he just wants to have it supervised so that they can slowly be weaned off.
It's like this weed situation.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wean off. Nah. Mm-hmm. So it's a little bit different. It's not like medical marijuana or in that kind of form, I think. So.
Gotcha. Yeah, that makes sense. I hear that. I don't know if I agree with this. Do you agree with this? It's a slippery slope, huh?
It's a slippery slope, yeah.
Okay, all right. Then we'll slip on out of that. Okay. Who's in the bathroom? North Carolina's largest city, Charlotte, passed a new law allowing transgender people to the right to choose public bathrooms that correspond to their gender identity. In a Charlotte City Council vote of 7-4, the mayor of the city, Jennifer Roberts, is pleased by the decision. The governor, Pat McQuarrie, he might be a transgender himself, is outraged.
Mm-hmm. Well, if he's outraged, then he's not.
Oh, that's so true.
That would make sense.
Well, he might be outraged because he wanted to be in all the bathrooms by himself. I don't know. This is a threat to the public safety. I agree, saying there. What do you think about that?
I'll take the opposite view. Because I'm more liberal. So
yes,
I feel like if a man who's now considers himself a woman, that's happened to me before.
You've
at
been
Macy's.
A man before?
A man, no, oh. Macy's. Mm-hmm. I've had two coworkers that used to be men. They're now women.
Okay.
And they've been in the bathroom, mm-hmm. I mean, washroom, and I haven't had a problem with it. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know if you might have a problem with it in the men's side because it's like an open stall mm-hmm. when you guys pee. Mm-hmm. So I heard, but it's not like that in the women's bathrooms. There's a door.
Sure.
So, I mean, I don't run around. It's not like a bathroom where I'm going to be like undressing or taking a shower or anything. So it doesn't really affect my life.
It doesn't affect
I'm
you.
Just being honest.
Oh,
like,
okay.
It doesn't really affect me.
Okay.
If I see somebody. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't like it.
I know you don't, Sir yeah. Walter Jones.
I don't like it because a man fears that he's slapping God in the face, number one. Mm-hmm. He's born one way, okay? He's born a man, and he decides he wants to be a woman, and now we've got to line up because he decides he wants to be another sex, and then you want me to allow you to be in the bathroom with me? I think it's a joke. It's deception at its best, and I'm going to move on to the next story. Today in history is, let me see, 1868, William Edward Burgard Dubois.
Is this W.E.D. Du Bois?
Uh-huh.
Okay. I was like, whose name is this?
Yeah, you know, I was trying to see how to pronounce his other name. Is that you know, he got...
The B part?
Yeah, he got four.
All right, so he has multiple names.
Well, he's an educator and a civil rights activist. He was born today, 1868, a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they say W.E.B. Du Bois.
Yes.
They try to act all intelligent when they say that.
They try to be French.
Yeah, they try to be French, but they need their French shut up. Wednesday, February 24, winter warning advisories. Making headlines news throughout the day were the winter advisories for several counties, including Cook and Kankakee. Snow totals were higher in the southern suburbs and blizzard-like conditions slammed into northwest Indiana. Southwest, they canceled 400 flights across the country, and O'Hare reported 975 cancellations. Did you get caught in this mess?
Well, as you know, I was working here.
You were working here.
So I came in, and it started doing the rain slash snow slash wind, and I couldn't see.
Mm-hmm.
And I was walking across the street. But then when I came out at 8 o'clock... It was barely snowing, and it looked like nothing happened. Like, it was just, like, a little bit of snow.
Yeah.
And I was disappointed by Blizzard 2016, but happy because I didn't want that much snow. But I'm just saying, that wasn't a real blizzard for Brittany.
Wasn't a real blizzard for you.
No.
You ever had that Blizzard ice cream?
No, actually, I have not.
It's good stuff.
I've been told.
It's a Dairy Queen, what?
Yes, yeah. It's Dairy Queen.
Yeah, man. You don't know what you're missing. That's some good stuff right there.
Maybe I'll have some soon.
Mm. Okay, yeah, all right. I'll treat you someday.
Yeah, because it's every time I'm near Dairy Queen, it's cold right now. So when I think about it, it's too cold. I don't feel like it's like two, three blocks from where I do my podcast. So I don't feel like walking with ice cream and being cold.
What is it about us eating ice cream in the wintertime anyway?
I don't know. It still tastes good. I still have lattes and fraps and cappuccinos cold, iced during the winter. I don't know.
I never did understand the latte, frappuccinos, Beyonce, and Clint Eastwood. All these names come from Starbucks. And, you know, I'm green. I'm new to it. I don't know what it means.
I don't know what it means either. It tastes good, though.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what is a frappuccino?
It's basically like having a shake but coffee in it.
Is it Al Pacino's brother?
Yes. Okay. Al Pacino is coffee and a shake.
Hey, Al, sorry, man.
He is offended.
He is quite offended. He's a good listener. Outside firing hits senior citizen. This was disturbing. A 76-year-old woman became a victim of gun violence as bullets being fired outside of her home came through her front window, striking her in the hand and the chest. Mm-hmm. Police responded to the Inglewood area, 7200 Sangamon, and are currently investigating the incident. No one is currently in custody. The woman is in stable condition at Advocate Christ Hospital. You heard about this?
Excuse me. Yes, I did.
What the heck is going on, man? I hear that whoever shot in the windows was trying to shoot in there to hit her relative.
Mm-hmm.
And she just happened to be the one in the living room.
I didn't hear that, but that's just like another of what is going on in people's families where they're
yes.
in somebody's just okay. I was raised very shielding, meaning okay. my family, my great grandmother, my great grandfather, my mom, my father, step parents, everybody. They knew exactly what I was doing, who I hung out with. Every point in which I left from the house, where I was, everything.
Mm.
So I'm not blaming her or anything, but what's going on in that house where you don't know that your son, grandson, who's ever in the house that they were targeting is a target. And like, why are you going to be living in this house, putting your family in danger, and allowing something like this to happen.
Yeah, that's the fear, too, of parents.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you don't know who your children are fellowshipping with, mm-hmm. befriending, and joining gangs and what have you. It's got to be rough, you know, if you're sitting there wondering, man, who's going to come in here and shoot me because something my son did or said or joined.
Mm-hmm.
It's got to be rough. And it affected, they could have taken this woman out.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she's old, so, well, she's 76 years, so that's older than me.
Mm-hmm.
That's over 20-some years older than me, still. Bones don't heal as fast as
right
as they used to. And she could have been sitting just to the right or to the left where that bullet could have went right into her head
mm-hmm.
or right to her heart, you know. It's just sad. Hillary Clinton, the black vote.
Oh, okay.
Hillary Clinton is trying to sway black voters her way as she continues to convince them that she will address their needs if elected. Speaking at the AKA function, I think that's the oldest black sorority is the AKA, actually. Clinton spoke about the ever-changing need of dealing with racism. You trust her?
One of my Facebook friends put up an article by the Huffington Post that was about Hillary Clinton and race and how she was acting when she was going against Obama, and it reminded me of stuff, so I would say no. About her sending emails talking about how he's a Muslim, he doesn't act American enough, twisting flaming the flames about him in regards to Reverend Wright and all of that thing and all of that stuff, not so much
it is amazing. Why don't you come back a few minutes? Okay.
Okay,
we're gonna take a break here. It is amazing how Clinton, we forget about how she was fighting tooth and nail it was Senator Obama at the time, all of the nasty things she was saying. We forget a lot of the stuff that the politicians say. We forget a lot of the stuff. And her own husband was like, yeah, he's a credit to their race. It's just funny stuff. Yes, sirree. Listen, I want to hear from my street reporter. She's probably out there, my investigative reporter, Marilyn Keeter, on the streets. We sent her out there to see if she could poll some of the people and ask them about Black History Month, since we're at the end. See what these people know about anything Black History. I like jaywalking. That jaywalking was amazing. But you realize how much people just didn't know. Yeah, Marilyn Keeter. We'll be right back, y'all. So will the Jones Show.
So, Walter, I'm taking it to the streets today to ask a few people about their knowledge in black history facts. Let's see what they have to say. How knowledgeable would you say that you are with black history?
Well, I say that I am maybe 50%.
50%? Okay, that's a good percent. That's a good percent. So I'm going to throw some names at you.
Okay.
And you tell me what's the first thing that comes to your mind.
Okay.
Okay, Thurgood Marshall. First thing that comes to your mind.
The army or the nation.
Okay, all right. What about who was the first woman to go into space?
She was a black woman.
Yep, she was a black woman. Yep.
But her name, I can't think of it right now.
But you know she was a black woman.
African-American, yes.
Okay, and one more question. This is the big one. Are you ready?
Yes.
Where did the Underground Railroad lead to?
Oh, wow. This is the easiest one. Oh, my God. It led to, I know this. Wow. It led to the, sorry, can we do this test when I come back?
How knowledgeable would you say that you are with black history?
Very knowledgeable.
Very knowledgeable. Uh-huh. Okay, I'm going to throw some information at you, and you tell me what's the first thing that comes to your mind. You ready? Okay, you've heard of DuSable Museum, right?
Yes, I have.
Okay, so what was he responsible for?
He was sponsored building Chicago downtown.
Okay. All right. That's good. Mm-hmm. That's a good answer.
Mm-hmm.
All right. What about this one? Who started Negro History Week? Also known as Black History
Week. Carter G. Woodson.
That's mm-hmm. good. Okay. All right. I got one more question. Let's make it 3 for 3. Okay. Who was Shirley Chisholm?
She was a congressman. She ran for the first black president, woman president.
Okay.
I mean, I know she's in Congress or whatever.
Okay.
And she ran for the first black president.
Okay.
Of the United States.
Okay.
I remember that real well.
Okay. All right. All right. Thank mm-hmm. you for mm-hmm. your responses. Okay. How knowledgeable would you say that you are in black history?
I'm knowledgeable.
Knowledgeable.
Yes.
Would you say 50%, 70%, 100%?
I'd say I'm about 45.
45.
Yes.
Okay, that's still a big number.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to throw some questions at you.
All right.
I'm going to test your knowledge in our history.
Come on with it.
Okay, I'm ready. Okay, who was Jack Johnson?
Jack Johnson was one of the first boxers.
Okay, all right.
The Great White Hope. He had that Great White Hope thing going, but he knocked that out of commission.
Right, right.
You know,
that's
yes.
true. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Here's another question. The Underground Railroad.
That's Harriet Tubman.
Okay.
She took slaves out of slavery to get them across to free land where they didn't have slavery, mm-hmm. like in Canada.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's good.
Mm-hmm.
All right, what about Mae Jemison?
Mae Jemison's first black astronaut.
Very good. Okay. I'm going to ask you one more. Who started Negro History Week, also known as Black History Month?
Who started Negro History Week, also known as Black History Month? Now, that one,
mm-hmm.
you might have me on.
Okay.
Let me take a guess. Negro History Week isn't that old.
Right.
And, I was about to go back all the way. I thought you were going back all the way, and I was going to tell you something about Frederick Douglass. But
what do you want to tell me about Frederick Douglass?
Well, you know, I can't really tell you anything about it right now because it's all you asked me a question.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay, I'm going to give you a hint. There's a library named after him.
There's a library named after him?
Mm-hmm. Carter.
G. Woodson?
There you go.
Oh, I didn't know. How? He didn't start Black History Month.
He started Negro History Week, and then that later became known as Black History Month. They extended the week into 4 weeks, and so that's how
okay. I didn't know that. Mm-hmm. You got me on that one.
Thank you. How knowledgeable would you say that you are with Black History? If you were to give me a percent... How knowledgeable would you say that you are?
65%.
65%. Do you realize that's a high number?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm going to throw some questions at you, and you tell me what's the first thing that comes to your mind. Okay. So the Underground Railroad, where did that lead to?
Where did that lead to? Who started it? Okay. Who started it is Harriet Tubman.
Okay.
Where did that lead to? Slaves getting free. So.
Okay. So now, was it an actual railroad that they boarded?
No, it wasn't an actual railroad. At all.
Okay. All right. Who started Negro History Month?
Frederick Douglass.
Frederick Douglass.
Yes, the reason why they call it Black History Month, but the reason why Frederick Douglass made Black History Month is because he wanted to make a month. Well, they made a month for us as African Americans, but he started it, should I say. He started it.
Okay. Who was the African-American doctor who performed open-heart surgery?
Not that one. I couldn't answer. I don't know that answer.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
This is Marilyn Keeter reporting for the Sir Walter Jones Show. Sir Walter, now back to you in the studio.
Boy, what a great interview. I was just cracking up at the brother. He said, I'm going to tell you about Frederick Douglass. She's like, okay, tell me about Frederick Douglass. Not now. Not now. My ham is baking in the oven. You got anything? Yeah, that was so funny to me. But I tell you, you'd be surprised how much we do not know about us. We don't know more, as much as we thought. She says a cottage. It's a library. He didn't even know it was a library named after.
That's a huge library.
Right. 95th Street, man. Mm-hmm. And he was like, Wilson? Yeah. What? He created the... You don't know no Martin Luther King. Okay. just amazing. Thank you, Marilyn Keeter, for being so bold. Sounded like you was in a railroad station or somewhere. trains.
She was at the Underground Railroad.
Boy, that was amazing. Keep that up, because that was just, that's funny. Where are we at Thursday? Heston, Kansas shooting rampage. Heston, Kansas. Just before 5 p.m., a shot rang out, as a 38-year-old. Cedric Ford. Some say Cedric, some say Cedric. Now, we have a Cedric Ford, or a Cedric Ford, that is a great friend of ours on Facebook. I got nervous when I heard the name. he is kind of crazy with Alvin, but I said, no, he wouldn't have done nothing this stupid. He killed three people and injured dozens of others at two different locations. Cedric worked at the XL Industries. You heard about this?
Yes, he shot some people near his job.
Yeah.
Or at his job. Yeah, it was at his job. And
it only happened a couple hours after he received a notice of restraint from, what they call those orders when you file some type of restraint against me?
Order of protection?
Yeah, but they called it something else. And then he got the order of protection at 3, and then at 5 o'clock he came back and decided to take revenge. It's just sad. Ford had an intensive criminal background, which included burglary and battery and concealed firearms. Now, that's stuff you need to be doing background checks on.
Mm-hmm.
And I guarantee you Uber is probably going to start doing that.
Yeah.
They're going to go back, like, you know how they do the P-tests for employees?
Mm-hmm.
They don't let you know when it's happening. They just say, as soon as you walk in, hey, we're going to do a P-test. You're like, oh, man, I just had some crack just last night.
I don't know if you're just going to, okay.
I'm telling you, that's the way it is. Well, Chicago red light and speed violations voided.
So what happened with red line?
Back in January of this year, we reported about the fraudulent misconduct of John Bills with the red flex traffic system here in Chicago.
Oh, okay.
All right. Circuit Court Judge Kathleen Kennedy ruled tickets given to motorists in Chicago for either a red light or speeding violation void. Insufficient notice and ticket contesting timeline the pocket of the city. The city was supposed to abide by its own rules regarding issues tickets, such as issuing second violation notices before issuing determinations of liability against a ticketed motorist, specifying, number two, specifying the makes of the vehicles, number three, notifying ticketed motorists they would be tagged with late fees 25 days after the city determined their liability, all this stuff. Of course, these rules were not completely carried out, and $600 million in fines were issued. $600 million from the city, you know. So now the question arises, of the thousands of motorists fined, just how many will receive refunds? Should the court give the green light in favor of the motorists?
I'm sure they're going to go case by case.
Yeah, that's a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
That's a slap in the face, too.
Sure is.
And the city's going to take it to a higher court. Trust me.
I'm sure they are.
They're not going to just let that one judge determine that. Bernie Sanders visits Chicago State University and the University of Chicago. This was yesterday, I believe. Democrats presidential candidate Sanders visited Chicago. That's why there's so much traffic out there yesterday. It almost took me forever to get home. He also joined the MSNBC College Tour with Chris Matthews at the University of Chicago.
Of all the people, they picked Chris Matthews to do the college tour? Okay.
Of all people.
Yes.
I don't know. I like Chris, though. He hardcore.
Mm-hmm.
He's not the most handsomest man in the world, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I know I just added a word, but he's not the most handsomest. But Chris is hardcore. I mean, it's called hardball, so.
Right. No, I just meant because he's old. They could have got Chris Haynes
true.
Like, young,
I get that.
More their You're age, right. But okay.
Because if he's writing about, who's that to be writing the books about killing presidents?
That's Bill O'Reilly.
Okay, that's Bill O'Reilly. Mm-hmm. But Chris, he's got books on presidents, too.
I think he does, too. Yeah.
Yeah. I think he's a JFK. I can't remember. The tour was open to students by invitation only, by the way. So you couldn't come, Brittany. I'm sorry.
I'll see if my sister went. She goes to Chicago State.
Oh, okay. Cereal sales have gone down. Have you heard about this?
No, I ate cereal this morning.
Okay, well, that's probably your last box. Are you crazy for Cocoa Puffs? Well, you may be alone as cereal sales have dropped 30% in recent years. Statistics show that many people have stopped eating their once favorite cereal brand due to, watch this, not eating breakfast, number one. Mm. So, of course, that's me, unfortunately. I do eat cereal, but only at night. I don't eat it in the day. I know it's weird. It tastes better at night.
Okay.
Yes. And number two, eating breakfast away from home or grabbing yogurt instead. 40% of millennials say it's too much of a hassle to eat cereal in the morning for breakfast because they have to clean up afterwards.
I eat cereal like every day, mm-hmm. and it's just a bowl.
They don't want to
and
clean
a spoon.
Bowl. And all that being lazy, 30% sales going down. That's crazy. You millennials, y'all. I'm trying not to say, what's the difference between an imbecile and a buffoon?
I'm neither of those things, so I don't know.
Okay, all right.
The difference.
Apples and oranges?
Yeah. But I don't know. Wow. It doesn't take that much time to clean out a bowl and a spoon.
Well, if you don't wash dishes, period, and you're waiting on your mama to do it, you just ain't gonna do it.
You could buy a dishwasher. Well, I guess if you're living at home, but I mean, like a dishwasher or something. That don't make any sense to me. I'm insulted.
I'm surprised that even came up as an excuse. Because, I mean, how many years I've been eating cereal and didn't feel like eating the bowl? I'm cleaning the bowl, that is. Not eating the bowl. Cleaning the bowl. But then I just let the dishes pile up in the sink because I wouldn't get another bowl because I didn't feel like cleaning the bowl I used yesterday. And got me some more cereal.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, that happened in my house. It don't happen as much, but it still do happen in my house. I'm bachelor. Me and my dog, Iris, we live the bachelor life. She's a bachelorette, actually. She's a woman.
Okay.
Today in history, 1948, MLK was ordained as a Baptist minister. 1948. Hmm? 1998, R. Kelly was won Best Male R&B Vocalist for his song, I Believe I Could Fry.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, today is Friday, February 27th. Budget Effects University, we just mentioned that, President Thomas J. Calhoun got him a pink slip.
Yep.
It's a shame. I don't know what to say about that. But I will say presidential candidates updates.
Okay.
Even though Cruz and Rubio are fighting each other in this race, they both are throwing arrows at Trump. Super Tuesday is only a few days away. Cruz said that Trump is a hypocrite for hiring undocumented immigrant workers. And Rubio is enraged at how Trump is using his wealth as a tinkering toy in front of voters.
Okay.
You agree with that?
Sure, but I don't like them either, so so it doesn't really matter. But yes,
you don't like who? Cruz and the other guy?
Rubio, no.
Rubio. Say his name again.
Rubio.
Rubio. Well, what do you think about this backing Trump thing with Chris Christie? How is it going to affect the election?
It's not. Okay. I mean, if the guy wasn't even popular before when he was running, Christie.
True.
Running for president, what difference does it make?
None.
Exactly.
Let's see what Facebook is saying before I respond to this mess.
Okay.
Alyssa Williams says, I don't know if this would be such an easy Democratic win, Sir Walter. Who would have thought that Trump would have even gotten this far? If he wins the Republican nomination, there are folks that will vote for a giraffe before voting for a Democrat. So true. And Antoine Isaac says, do you mean before voting for a woman? Yeah. You agree with her?
I agree that... I can't believe he's gotten this far.
No either. One can.
And if I would just hope that, oh my gosh, please don't have Trump be the president of the United States. Yeah. That'd be awful.
That would be awful. That's a screensaver, right?
Yes.
Okay. Angela Gare says we are on a downward spiral spinning so fast that we can't apply brakes. She's shaking her head. Kista Lynn Patterson says the day will come when people desire the leadership of President Barack Obama. Okay.
Why you say it like that? Like, okay.
I'm not sure what that meant, but
I think she's saying that years from now people will look back and go like, that was a good presidency.
You know what? I totally agree with her with that statement. You know why I agree with her?
Why, Sir Walter?
Well, let me tell you why.
Okay.
Because this happens a lot in history.
Mm-hmm.
When a president is in office at that time,
mm-hmm.
you just don't know what his effect's going to be
right.
just yet. And he could leave office 4, 5, 10 years later, and you still don't know
mm-hmm.
how bad he was or how good he was. Sometimes it takes many years,
right?
And a lot of times, what they do, they would put him up against whoever the next president is and the next president after that. Then they'll say, oh, my God, Ronald Reagan was the best man that we've ever had.
Okay.
The Republicans, they worship him.
Mm-hmm.
All right. We wasn't saying much about that when he was in office.
Mm-hmm.
And we wasn't saying that when Bush Sr. was in office that much.
Mm-hmm.
I think it wasn't until after Bill Clinton, either mm-hmm. was in office or left the office, then we began to reflect on Ronald Reagan,
mm-hmm.
how great he was.
Mm.
Okay?
Okay?
I'm not saying he was great. I'm just saying.
No, you can say that if you want to. I'm sorry.
I like Ronald Reagan. Mm-hmm. I really did. I liked him. I think I liked not so much his policies. I just liked his character. Mm. I'm telling you, me and him would have been best friends if we had been, boys.
Okay.
Because I understand him, and he was once a Democrat, so that's probably, and I'm not a Democrat or Republican. I'm a, I don't know.
An independent?
I'm independent. I'm a conservative.
Mm-hmm.
I have some liberal sides and I have some conservative. I'm mostly conservative sides and I have some liberal sides. All right.
So you're sliding towards moderate, but then you go kind of back to conservative.
Yeah.
I don't know how to describe that.
I think you see, and people, my mom said it all the time. Who are you? So I get what she's saying, Kister Lynn. She's right. President Obama's right now is he's hated. He's the most hated man in office right now, especially by Republicans and conservatives and moderates and what have you, okay?
Right.
Even some in the left don't like him.
Right, because they don't think he's left enough.
That's my whole point. All right. It won't be until many years later till we'll see the impact even of Obamacare. If it's still in the running, you know, because everybody in the Republican office say, if I get in there, that's the first thing I'm going to get rid of. That ain't going to be easy. Trust me on that. You just can't just say, all right, my first thing on the day, I'm get rid of Obamacare. And then you're going to spend 4 years trying to get rid of it. And you're not going to be no good for nothing else.
Right.
I think that's sad. That's a waste of our tax dollars. Lisa Ivy says, I just don't know what to say. I'm with Angela. God help us. Art Lewis says, can't be any worse than the first election in Russia after the collapse of the Soviet Union. And Natalie says, that's comforting. That's comforting. Art also says, actually, yes, it is. People were murdered and other horrible things took place that are that we ourselves are not experiencing. The unfortunate aspect is this has become a circus act to which history tells us had gone on before as well. I've never seen this kind of act, though, in politics, what I've been seeing in these debates. I've never seen it like this. I don't know. Have you ever been paying attention to old debates and compared it to what we have now?
No, it was kind of teetering that way the last election, but
with
Mitt Romney and all of them. But it wasn't as much because they didn't have a character like Trump in there. I think Trump was there for a second and then he dropped out. And so, no, it was a little bit more civil. But I mean, they're still sniping and interrupting each other and stuff during the debates.
I agree with that. And I think it's because of the antics of Trump. He stirs up the pot. It's like that one bad apple. I think evil communication corrupts good manners. So I think Cruz and Rubio and the man who falls asleep at the mic, the doctor.
Carson?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, him. I think they are... Carson's very, you know, if you pay attention to the debates, you'll see how he's trying to be the guy who smoothed things over. You know, one debate he says, let's bow our heads for a moment of silence. People are like, man, shut up and talk. Okay.
Well, I saw that clip and I thought the same thing. Like, he was just saying that to look nice instead answering the question.
Yeah, he was trying to look presidential. I see what he's trying to do because he's trying to be the outsider. He's looking at all these kids fighting in the sandbox, and he's like, I'm not like this, guys. You know, he did that just last night in the debate. They said, oh, you have opening remarks. He's like, we need to be calm. We need to stop fussing at each other. Then I said, he's trying to be, you know, he's doing what I probably would do. But unfortunately, the audience was waiting on some whips to crack. They wanted this fiasco. So he didn't know his audience.
Yeah.
Because they just ignored him. They ignored him. Our brother Scott says, what better way to say that you want to be vice president? I guess she's talking about Chris Christie. Yeah. That's a good way of putting it, Brony. I didn't think about that. Halliburton says, it's going down like the Titanic. Lord have mercy on America. Michelle Thomas says, it's never too cold for ice cream. She must be listening. How did I know that? Antoine says, you might not believe this, but I just made a bowl of ice cream and sat down to listen to the show. Ironic, isn't it? Ain't that something?
What kind of ice cream?
Yeah, tell us what kind it is, Antoine, if you're still listening. He got a C. What's that license you give him when you get the truck driver's license? CDL. Yeah, he just got his CDL. Now he's excited and he's going to be on the road and he won't be able to listen to us next week. I'm going to be on break anyway next week.
You are going to. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, hallelujah. But Wednesday, we got a very important show. We're bringing in some of the greatest men in politics. Will be coming in to join forces with us. I'm taking a break from my break. Just that day so that I could talk to these men. Of course, attorney. He don't like me saying attorney, but that's what he is. Pastor Andre Johnson will be back on the show. Also, we have my high school buddy will be here. Who is it? Well, Larry Rogers.
It's like, who is it?
Who is it? Larry Rogers will be here Wednesday as well. He's a partner. He's an attorney, I believe he is. Yeah, he's a trial lawyer. Been a trial lawyer a long time. And then I've got Tavis. Yeah, Travis, Bishop Travis Grant will be here. You always see his face on the news. Him and Andre Holmes. Is it Andrew Holmes? I think that's his name. You always see their faces because they're the ones that the shakers and the makers of our city, trying to figure out what they can do to enhance the plight of the African American. What did I miss in news, Brittany?
I don't remember their names, but I don't know if you saw my my Facebook page, mm-hmm. that lawmakers, Republican lawmakers in Illinois, are trying to introduce a bill that would say if a woman is having a baby and she's a single mother, that the kid can't have a birth certificate.
Right.
So basically, like, if the father is not in the child's life and the mother decides to have the baby, mm-hmm. they're not allowed to have a birth certificate. If they can't give you a DNA, or the father won't give a DNA sample to prove he's the father, they won't allow the kid to have a birth certificate.
So what's the solution?
The solution would be that they shouldn't introduce this bill. Because if you don't have a birth certificate, you can't go to college, you can't do certain things, you can't have a job. And then the same politicians are supposed to be pro-life. If you want this woman who, after maybe things didn't work out or the guy left her or she was raped, to have a baby, then why are you going to punish her and the baby? So there's like no compassion, in my opinion.
Who's doing this?
Let me get the article up. It's a Illinois Republican. So this is it's in our state. They're trying to introduce this, and trying to get the name of the Congress people, because that doesn't even make any sense to me. Yeah. It says, yeah, they said if there is no father to sign the birth certificate, the state will not issue that child a birth certificate, which means they're barred from public schools and going to get college, or for the mother to get any aid for the baby if they need help paying for just their life. I'm trying to see who's the actual people who wants to have this.
They're punishing the child for being born.
Exactly.
That's amazing. I pray that that's one of those satire websites.
It's not satire, but I don't think it's going to go anywhere. No. It's the Republicans are John D. Cavaletto, mm-hmm. and Keith Wheeler. Hmm. They're the ones that sponsored in the act. It would amend the state's Vital Records Act.
You think that they're doing this are they profiling, you think?
Yes, I do think they're profiling, because they said the exception would be artificial insemination. And who can afford artificial insemination? Rich people.
Wow.
So, yeah, they're definitely targeting poor minority people.
Yep, that's exactly what it is. Who's sitting next to your child? A 23-year-old Ukrainian man has been posing as a high school honor student in Pennsylvania.
Why? He's 23.
I have no idea. Arthur Sumerian, alias Asher Potts, was arrested and charged.
What's up with this? I've read somebody, you know, the doctor love pervert dude.
Yep.
Then there's a guy who, there's a whole bunch of people who have tried to be cops, mm-hmm. and a senator.
Yep.
One Indian guy, he was trying to be a senator, and he did like talks. He got paid to do a talk at a college or something.
Ain't that something?
What is with the vetting?
Right,
people?
Who's vetting these people, or the lack thereof? He had a Pennsylvania driver's license in Potts' name when he was arrested. Police believe that the identity was made up, and no one's identity has been compromised. His visa had run out, and he has been living here for about 4 years. He lives with people, and he befriended. He figured to him, you know what? Since I can't go back home, I might as well make the best of this. Well, the worst came out of his best. And today in history, 1869, 15th Amendment guaranteeing the right to vote was sent to the states for ratification. Mm-hmm. In 1928, singer Fats Domino was born. I'm walking. Yes, indeed.
Is he still alive?
That's a good question.
I was just wondering.
Let's find out on the interwebs. I think I have Fats Domino over there. Brittany, as we get off this air, I'm tired. I'm going.
Okay, I can try to find it.
Thank you, Brittany. We love you, girl. We're going off the air because I think we're going to just do this album and get out of here. Fats Domino. That sounds Italian, and Domino's. Is that Italian or is that Latin? Domino's. Domino's. 88. Yeah, he born 1928. He is 88 years old. And I'm looking at Wikipedia, and it don't say he died, so he's still around. Yeah, yeah. I'm walking. Yes, indeed, I'm talking about you and me. I think that. Oh, just type in Fats Domino. I know we did him on the show, unless he's part of the show where you know, we all got rid of all my files, so he might be part of them for that file.
He might be part of, yeah.
Yeah, he might. Yeah, he gone.
So what song would you like to do that?
All right, we're going to do an outro since we were so still talking about the commission show we did. I'm going to pull up my commission notes here, and I'm going to go to my other favorite song here. 1 second here. Commission, where are you? Okay, I got you. Go to the bottom of the screen. And I think I'm going to do When Love Calls You Home. 77. When Love Calls You Home by the Commission. This is on the Matters of the Heart album. 1994, I'm not sure what you guys were doing then, but I might have been in front of the TV watching The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Y'all meet me here Monday, 4 o'clock. President Obama and Michelle, I'm so sorry we didn't get a chance to interview you, but we'll get you in Monday. We love you guys. Go to Spreaker.com. Share the show with everybody you can. Have a great weekend. Stay out of trouble. Love the Lord your God and all of his commandments. Keep them. And you will have eternal life. So, Walter Jones Show.
Dangling somewhere in the dark. Doubting if anybody really cares. Until love reached through the shadows, whispering your name. Nothing will ever be the same again. 'Cause when love
ladies and gents, if you missed any of today's show, head to Spreaker.com and search the Sir Walter Jones Show and listen to this show and past shows. Now remember, search for the Sir Walter Jones Show on Spreaker.com. That's Spreaker spelled Spreaker.com. And enjoy.
You have been listening to the Sir Walter Jones Show, where Sir Walter Jones provides you with a biblical perspective on everyday life. Stay connected to Sir Walter Jones at his website, www.sirwalterjones.com. Search the Sir Walter Jones Show on Facebook or follow on Twitter at Sir Walter's Music. Until next time, thank you for listening to the Sir Walter Jones Show with Sir Walter Jones.
Right, Mr. Walters.